The point of this model is not so much about speed than off-road capability and precision. I redesigned the front axle to increase the ground clearance of the under the wheels. So now it's the axle has one stud more of a ground clearance compared to the original. In the original, the suspension arms go straight, and here you can see they go up, so you have much more clearance. I also increased the gear ratio here to give the model a bit more speed. One of the things that I also improved was the steering angle. So the steering angle of the original is around 20-25 degrees, while this one reaches over 30 degrees, as you can see here. Increasing the steering angle makes the model much more maneuverable, which improves, of course, the possibilities you can do while driving outside. It makes climbing over things much easier, especially at stages where you need to be very precise to get to through certain points or checkpoints or things like that. So yes, the steering angle has been increased, and generally the model is much more maneuverable than originally. So, second modification I did was I replaced the original differential with a new reinforced one, because the original differential could not withstand the additional power provided by the motors when it's powered by BuWizz. When I replaced the original battery box with the BuWizz, is that the central differential would just start clicking, because it was the old type, which only used 3 gears instead of 5 the new one uses. So the first thing I had to do was replace the central differential. After replacing the central differential and modifying the axles, I no longer had any problems with gears skipping. And the last limb, on the rear, first thing I did was I changed the shock absorbers in the back with the soft ones, which increases the response of the rear suspension. And I also redesigned the whole rear axle. So the rear axle is now based on 7x11 frames. I reduced the number of gears going to the rear axle. So originally there were 4 gears going here to the differential, and now there are just 2, which increases the efficiency, and I also slightly increase the gearing of the axle. The differential lock is still here, and the ground clearance has also been increased by 1 stud, just like in the front. The model's total gear ratio was slightly increased, and thanks to the additional power provided by BuWizz, the model can now reach a much higher top speed. So, the original model can reach around 10 centimeters per second, while our modified version can reach 16 centimeters per second, which is around 60% increase, while having high enough torque to basically climb over everything, I guess. There is still a possibility we can also change the original drive motors to the BuWizz ones if you want even more speed, but that will require additional modification, and basically you have to tear down the entire model then. If there's one thing I would like to improve at this model is if there was a possibility also to add a front differential, or maybe just use a different model as a base altogether, like a Unimog, because the Unimog is much shorter and it has a much better climbing performance.
Oops. Yes! Come on!
This is Zetros! Do it!
Yay!
Great model and excellent driver. Unbeatable combination.